this is what I call a Christmas tree. Hi, Kenny from Hangar 51. Merry Christmas. Today we're going to talk about my airplane tree that holds 8 airplanes in a 2 foot by 2 foot square. Of course, the planes take up more room than that, but the base of the tree itself is 2 foot by 2 foot, probably about $25 worth of PVC, and here you are. So let me get these planes off the tree and we'll take a look at how it's built. Okay, yeah, I know. Yeah, but what if you only put one airplane in it? It's just gonna flip over, right? I know you're asking that, okay? 1700 millimeter FMS P-51 Mustang, almost 11 pounds on the top shelf by itself, okay? It's not going to tip over. These legs prevent it from going anywhere. It cannot fall over. Even with an 11 pound airplane on the top, it's not falling over. So yes, it can handle any amount of planes you want. Remember guys, even if I stacked all planes on this side, okay, it's not going to tip over because the weight's getting lower every time, and it's going out, but it's getting lower. It's not going to tip over. This is the worst case scenario, an 11 pound plane on the top. If it was going to tip over, now's the time. It's not going to tip over. So yes, it can handle any size airplane, and it doesn't matter. You know, it's going to travel down the road. If you only had to put one plane in it, chances are if you're only putting one plane on it, you don't need the rack. You just put it on the ground. But even if you want to travel in the rack, yes, it can handle just one plane. There it is. You know. So I know you were asking. There it is. Okay, so this is what the rack looks like with no planes on it. And I just want to go over the dimensions with you a little bit and then construction. And it works out really well, as you saw with the planes. And it's 2 foot by 2 foot. So, and the bottom. So it's a 2 foot square. On the top, 1 foot by 2 foot. Unfortunately, mine's not 2 foot this way because I added these T's here and here for the legs. So that made it a little wider than 2 foot. And that made it wide enough that it won't go out my 28 inch door. So, yeah, so I had to cut it. Okay, but that actually worked out good, and I'll show you why. You know, depending on how wide a door you have, because now the total of this with these and the corners makes this about a little over 30 inches. So it's really tight going out a door. But if you cut it in the middle and then either put a T or just a union to hold it together and don't glue that part, you can pop it apart, narrow it up, goes right through a door easy now, because now you're only talking about 2 foot at the top plus the little bit, but you know, it goes through a door much easier. It's much easier to move it around when you can do this with it. And then when you get it where you're going, you snap these back together and you're good to go. So I only had one extra one, so I'll put one there. Not a big deal. But so that's it. So this design is very basic measurements. I didn't make anything fancy. It's all round digits. 1 foot sections here. 1 foot sections on the wing holders. 45s on the ends. Just the regular 45 unions. And then I've got 3 inch and 3 inch, or are they six? They're 6 inch. 6 inches here, so that these are staggered. So if you put a high wing plane here, the motor's here, you put a high wing plane here, the motor's here, and they miss each other, okay? Or a low wing and a low wing. The only time it becomes a problem is when you do a high wing and a low wing. As the high wing drops the motor down, and now it's in line with the low wing, and the motors are going to do this. It's not really a problem at the bottom. It's plenty wide enough, but at the top, it can be a little... So you got to manipulate it a little bit. And, of course, you can tighten these. If you know the size planes you're putting on here, you can certainly tighten these up and get a lot more planes in the same space. You know, I did just a general 8 plane rack so that I could put all different size planes on it, as you saw, and that's worked out fine. But as my inventory grows, I might build a second one of these and have specific measurements for specific planes, and probably get maybe 10 or 12 planes on it instead of only 8. But yeah, it's a great rack, really love it, works great. Again, all the measurements are just round numbers. Measure your own stuff, measure your door, make sure it'll fit out the door, and then measure your planes, tighten these up if you want to, stagger them a little more if you need to. You know, the options are unlimited. You just need, just remember, you know, you need 2 T's per shelf, per side. Okay, so I've got 8 shelves, that's, you know, 8 and 8 T's, 16 T's I needed, and then 2 more on the bottoms here on each side for the legs, so a total of 20 T's. You need 8 corners, okay, and this is all half inch PVC. The gray stuff's cheaper, get it in the electrical department, it's the exact same stuff, it's only gray and it's a little cheaper. If you want the white, then just get the white and the plumbing, but all the fittings are plumbing. And yeah, that's all you really need. You need 8 of the corners and 20 of the T's, and you're gonna need 16 of the 45s to put on the ends of here. And then it's, these are 1 foot, 1 foot, 1 foot, 2 foot, 2 foot, 2 foot, 2 foot, 2 foot, 2 foot. Real simple. And you just glue it all together. Again, stagger it, you know, the 6-inch here, 6-inch here, the stagger it, and that way the motors don't, you know, they're gonna do this in the middle. And it's a great little rack, works great, you know. Put any kind of airplane you want on it, works great. So I hope you like that, hope, I think it's a good idea. If you do, comment at the bottom, like me here on YouTube, like me on Facebook, and we'll see you on the next review. Talk to you later, bye-bye.